Hi. There's a lot that we can actually learn from specifically nature and how we can adapt to our personal and business life, specifically in the current situation, what's prevailing globally and also in India. Let's take the life of a river. From the time it starts as a trickle, normally a collection of rainwater or sometimes a source, if it is Himalayas, from the mountains, it slowly gathers momentum. In the initial stages, if you look at it, it's a very, very, very thin stream. And as it flows along, it gathers momentum. The way a business does, you start small. Just because you are small, you don't stop. You have the confidence that as you go along, you will become something large. If you take the life of a river, as you would like to compare it with our business or personal life, it has a very large goal. The largest goal is for it to go back and merge into the sea or ocean. If you take the rivers all over the world, not even just maybe one or two, which are what we call as landlocked. Every other sea finds a way to the destination. That is the kind of determination and focus we must have in our business too. The journey for some of the rivers is a few hundred kilometers. There are some very long rivers which runs for 1,000+ kilometers before it reaches the sea or the ocean. One thing that we have to learn from there for surely is it just does not give up. There are several hurdles that the river comes across on its way to the ocean. Bad terrain, unable to navigate in the land that it is flowing through, people damming it up, whatever it may be. But river beats it all by the sheer resilience and perseverance to find its way to the goal. One great aspect of the river, why it's revered by all, is that wherever it is, it serves those people through whom it's passing through. The same is true for our business. Wherever we are present, however we are present, our fundamental job of the business is not to make profits, is not to make turnover. They are all outcomes. Our fundamental output, as I would like to call, is to serve. When we serve, the resultant turnover or profit is bound to happen. We also have a lot to learn from the river. Many, many more things. On its way, it allows other rivers, which are either small or whatever, to come and join it. They are all called as tributaries. The tributaries come and join the river, what is called as a confluence. Maybe because on its own, it won't be able to reach the ocean or the sea. The same way in our business, times might come when we might have to join hands with a larger force. In corporate or business parlance, we might call it mergers and acquisitions. The confluence of like-minded business and service, specifically in tough times, is one option that you need to really look at. Collaborate, co-create, maybe create a confluence so that your goal of having to reach the ocean or the sea is not stopped. There are also times when the sea really is near, but what you would find suddenly is that the river splits and then finds multiple streams to go and reach the ocean. You call them as tributaries or distributaries, which runs away from the river and still on its way irrigates, helps people, and then goes and joins the sea or the ocean. The way you run a business, there are times when you can create multiple streams of business, not just stick to one single product or service which was relevant till yesterday, which I mean the pre-COVID days. Post-COVID, you may have to reshape, you may have to restructure, you may have to repackage the products and service, maybe find a new product or service that the current market scenario would need. If you really look at the time that it takes for one droplet of water from the time it drops from the top of a mountain till it reaches the ocean, it's a pretty long drive. But it doesn't give up. On its way, it irrigates the fields. It also cultivates or creates good sand for the land to become more fertile. There's a lot it does, of course, quenching the thirst of the people, and so many things it does. But one thing that is very important, it just does not stop anywhere. It's ready to join hands the way we are all working together in an organization with others. A river has no ego. It does not say, I will not mix with this specific water. I will not go and talk to this specific droplet. It joins ways with anything and everything. On its way, goes to the ocean. The journey sometimes can be months together before it goes off from the top of a mountain to the ocean. The same way in the current situation, where many experts now are predicting a redefined drawing board. They are saying that the survival phase will just not be 3 to 6 months, but it can go between 12 to 18 months. I was reading a very famous quotation of a very senior or a very powerful businessman in the world, many of you may be aware. He was saying, the founder of Alibaba, Jack Ma, he was saying that next 12 to 18 months, just surviving is equivalent to making profit. Because the entire business line, the product line, everything that we are seeing has been redrawn completely. It is time for us to survive. By just surviving for 12 to 18 months, which needs a different set of strategy, mindset, there are enough people to help you with that. If you are able to do it, that is sufficient, because many others would have been thrown out of business. And when things stabilize and then when you bounce back, you will find that you have redrawn your DNA. You have done things which were not possible earlier in your own mindset. So the next 9 to 12 months almost, redrawing the business strategy just on survival, meeting your cash expenses, breaking even, or sometimes taking money out of your long-term assets and repositioning them in your current or liquid positions. A lot of strategies that are at place that can be discussed and that will help you to survive. The focus is not on a certain expansion. The focus is not on making turnover or profit changes, but the focus is a honorable survival, where you are able to break even, meet your basic OPEX, and ensure that next 9 to 12 months you are going to survive. After that you stabilize, and there are ways in which you will find you will be able to surge ahead. The way in which a river does not give up before it meets the final destination, please ensure that whatever it takes, you also do to ensure that you survive the next 9 to 12 months. Help is available. It's up to you to go and ask without ego. People will help you with or without cost. It's my earnest wish and prayers that you survive this onslaught, and we will all be able to go together towards a stabilization period and then surge ahead. We will do it together. Thank you.